Hello, a warm welcome to you from SGT University. I am Mukesh Kumar, Faculty of Science. Today, you will be learning about transmitter and receiver. In this video, you will learn about basics of transmitter, super heterodyne receiver, its block diagram, and working principle. Let us start with the basics of transmitter. The function of a transmitter is to produce a carrier signal coded with message signal and to supply enough power to the coded carrier signal. There are three major subdivisions of a basic transmitter. First, an exciter section that generates the carrier signal. This section includes carrier oscillator, a buffer amplifier, and a tuned RF amplifier. This group of circuits is responsible for the constancy of carrier frequency. The accuracy and stability of oscillator frequency is a major concern in any transmitter, and it can be improved by using a crystal oscillator in order to control the frequency and controlling the temperature of the crystal by placing it in an oven. Second, a power section. It sets the energy level required for the transmission without affecting the carrier frequency. It includes driver amplifier and modulated power amplifier. The driver amplifier is a low power amplifier, ranges from 0.5 to 5 watt with low output impedance. The final power amplifier is usually a class C amplifier or a class B push-pull amplifier. It depends on the modulating condition. Third, modulator section. It modulates the message signal and supplies the modulating power. It includes message input, pre-amplifier, voltage amplifier, and modulator power amplifier. Now, let us discuss super heterodyne receiver and its working principle. Let us discuss super heterodyne receiver. First, I will discuss about basics of super heterodyne receiver. After that, block diagram of super heterodyne receiver. Basics of super heterodyne receiver. Since at high frequency, processing of a signal is very costly. Thus, we need to process the signal at low frequency. Hence, we need to convert high frequency signal into low frequency signal. At low frequency, for the transmission of a signal, we require high size of antenna. Therefore, transmission cost of the signal will be high. Also, at lower frequency, band is low. So, signal transmission should be done at high frequency. So, in super heterodyne receiver, we take care of the above mentioned point, that are signal processing at lower frequency and signal transmission at higher frequency. Block diagram of super heterodyne receiver. Here first we have antenna, and this antenna will receive radio frequency signal or RF signal. This RF signal will having high frequency. After antenna, there is RF amplifier. In RF amplifier, there is low noise amplifier, LNA. Reason behind is that signal received from antenna is having high noise, and we need to remove this noise at first stage so that very low noise can transfer to the rest of the circuit. After RF amplifier, we will have a strong signal with very low noise. This signal is transferred to mixer or first detector circuit. So, at mixer circuit, there will be two input, one from RF amplifier, that is FRF, and second from local oscillator, that is FLO. Mixer circuit mixes these two signals, FRF and FLO. Hence, at output of mixer circuit, there will be two signal, first FRF plus FLO and second FRF minus FLO. Here, our main motive is to transfer lower intermediate frequency, that is FRF minus FLO, to next stage. So, at this stage, we don't consider FRF plus FLO signal, we consider only FRF minus FLO signal. Next step, lower intermediate frequency is transferred to IF amplifier or intermediate frequency amplifier. After signal amplification at IF amplifier, transfer to second detector. Second detector circuits also consist of a mixer circuit and local oscillator circuit, and with the help of this circuit, IF signal converted into message signal. This message signal transferred to power amplifier, and after amplification by power amplifier, message signal transferred to the speaker. Let us discuss characteristics of receivers. First, selectivity. Its ability of receiver to select desired signal and reject unwanted signal. Now, how to justify the selectivity of a receiver? For that, there is a parameter called quality factor, denoted by Q. Quality factor Q is equal to FC divided by BW, where FC is central frequency and BW is bandwidth. If Q is very high, then quality of receiver is very good. From figure, it is clear that quality factor of first curve is good and for second curve, it is poor. Basically, the quality which justify the selectivity that explain you how a receiver selects the desired signal and reject the unwanted signal. Second parameter, sensitivity. Sensitivity is the ability of receiver to pick weak signal and amplify it. So, it explains you how much weak signal that could received by receiver. And it totally depends upon the gain of amplifier which is there in the receiver. Therefore, gain of the amplifier should be high. Third, fidelity. Its ability of receiver to reproduce all the frequency components of message signal. So today we covered transmitter and receivers. Next time we meet, we'll be exploring about radar and its applications. Keep learning, keep growing. See you next time.